Hey guys, this is Christine from Fintiva. We hope you're all safe and sound out there. Following up on our second Q&A video on general blocked account topics, I want to welcome you to the third session where we want to answer to your questions about visa processing and administrational topics. So we reached out to embassies and foreign offices and want to summarize answers in the following, which they have given us in an email exchange. But at first, I want to start with the good news that travel bans, especially for outside Europe, are also slowly being lifted. As of Friday, the 17th of July, Germany was permitting citizens from 8 non-EU countries to visit without restrictions. Countries with high COVID-19 rates, such as the US, India and Russia, are not on the list. Germany continues to update its travel list every 2 weeks. Since the 15th of June, anyone traveling from inside the EU, the Schengen zone, or the UK has been allowed to enter Germany. Regarding the final student visa processing, is in general now once again possible everywhere. However, the corona situation is different in many countries, so this also affects the work of some visa offices. And unfortunately, there may still be restrictions in the services offered by the visa offices. Wherever possible, student visas are already being issued again, for example in China, where the demand is quite high. At the moment, there are some specialties to consider for your plans to study in Germany. The authorities need proof in form of a document in the visa procedure that the studies cannot be completed abroad, if necessary, also in the form of an email from the respective university. In addition to the usual notification of admission, the university must now confirm that a student's presence in Germany is required and from when. Language students can also enter the country, but only if they want to attend a preparatory language course for the studies and already have an admission from a German university. Participants of an isolated language course are unfortunately not yet allowed to enter the country. It is important, however, that the quarantine regulations of the respective federal states are observed in parallel with the entry restrictions and their exceptions. When entering from a risk area designated by the RKI, a quarantine is generally required first. About the foreign offices and embassies, we can say that they are slowly taking up their services again. And you can find the operating times online on their websites. There you can also find constantly updated information regarding the visa processing. As the corona situation is still different from country to country, some offices are still not able to offer a normal operation, such as in Cameroon, as they are still in the middle of the pandemic. In some countries, such as in Turkey, you have to expect an increase in appointment waiting times at the general consulate. Speaking for the foreign offices, there has to be made a distinction between a visa and residence permit. A visa serves to enter Germany from abroad and is applied for at the respective German mission abroad. This is the responsible authority and makes the final decision on the visa procedure. After entering with the corresponding visa, a residence permit is applied for at the domestic foreign authority. In general, a large number of visa applications are expected before the start of the semester, and the distributions of their capacities will be adjusted and prioritized accordingly. As visa applications are submitted to the respective German missions abroad, it is difficult for them to make an assessment at the moment. As long as they are involved in the procedure, there will be no delays and the processing will continue just as before. There are no restrictions to be expected. Of course, all of the offices will make sure to provide several health measures in order to make you feel safe at your visit. In all embassies and consulates, preparations are made with regard to compliance with hygiene standards. Masks will be compulsory for all visitors, and a distance of 2 meters has to be maintained. In some offices, they will also check your temperature. Many of you were interested what happens with already issued visas, which have now been expired. As soon as the resumption of visa application acceptance becomes apparent, case-specific information on this will be published on the website of the respective office. In Turkey, it is already possible to apply for a visa at the general consulate or its external service provider. In India, you can hand in an application for reissue until the 13th of August. After this date, a new application with all documents has to be handed in. Please also revise here on the website of your respective office, or you can also call them and ask for advice. When the authorities will open again depends on each country. Many of them are still closed for visitors or meetings are only possible with an appointment. However, current visa applications will continue to be processed. The opening of the General Consulate for visitors will be in line with the lifting of contact and travel restrictions. For the latest information, you should also check their websites. But we can also say that they are always available via email and telephone as well. So guys, we hope we could answer to all of your questions and that our videos was of help to you. Please let us know if you have any feedback for us. Stay healthy. From our homes to your homes, to 50 bedrooms.